This is a video showing how to calculate the time of flight using a forest platform. So the primary work for this workbook is done within the calculator. So the first set of calculations are to add the forces between two forest platforms. This workbook can also be configured for a single forest platform. So the first line is summing the normal forces from two forest platforms. This can be done either with a one-axis or a two-axis forest platform. The next line here is testing to see if the normal force for the sum of the forest platforms is less than 5% of the initial value. This will make sure that the timing will only take place when the normal force drops below a certain critical value. This value can be reduced further below 0.5 if desired. There is a certain amount of running to the forest platforms, so that sometimes there can be some variation in forces even when the subject has left the surface. So this value can be adjusted to make sure that you're getting the best values. The hang time is calculated by the number of data points under which the normal force is below a certain critical threshold, and that's what the hang time level has done. I've configured this to report out in seconds. The weight of the subject can also be determined. Prior to the jump, the workbook records the sum of the forces, records the first value of that, and then records that as the weight of the subject. And then the mass of the subject can be calculated by dividing by the acceleration due to gravity. The jump height is determined by taking half the hang time and putting that into the kinematic equations to determine how high the subject has jumped. This does not take into account the changing center of mass of the subject, so any motion of the arms would certainly change the center of mass of the subject. Within this workbook, I have a simple display here, which it displays the hang time in seconds, the jump height in meters, and then also has the weight of the subject that's determined at the start of the run in newtons, and then the mass of the subject in kilograms. This workbook will be linked to below this video, and the calculations will also be placed in the comments for this video.